Hi, happy Friday. I have my front door open. Welcome back to my channel. Bruce is doing well. He had his appointment on Monday. The oncologist gave him a smaller dose of chemo. I think pretty soon we are going to discuss in August whether we're going to stop his chemo completely, because I think his cancer now is almost completely in clinical remission, or if we're just going to still give him a dose and then just really spread it out. The visits. So his cardiologist appointment did not happen. His appointment for that mysteriously disappeared, because we were supposed to see him also on Monday after we saw the oncologist. But we were able to get an appointment for him. We can decide what we're going to do next with Bruce's treatment and how we should move forward, because Bruce does have other health issues that we need to handle and take care of. But thank you for your well wishes for him. I really appreciate it. We really appreciate it. He's currently on the couch asleep. So let's see if I can finish filming before he decides he wants to play. So in front of you, I have my Hobonichi cousin. My Hobonichi A5 HON is in here, which I use as my writer's notebook. So let's flip through that one first. This is how I use my monthly layout. I put down just the important appointments or like significant things that I need to remember. So like every 2 weeks we get our street clean, so I need to make sure my car is moved so I don't get a ticket. I have a medical appointment later in the month. We have a family gathering this weekend, water delivery. The 4th of July was on Thursday. Bruce's flea heart med was on the 1st, and then here was his cardiology oncology appointment, which did not happen. So I crossed out the cardiologist appointment, but then we did have his oncology appointment. This is my weekly layout. And this is something that I will either fill in the night before or the morning of. And as you can see, today's Friday, haven't done that yet. And then my mail I put over here. And the washi tape is from JetPens. So this is the layout for this week. And then this is the layout for last week. So for the start of July. And then just to show you what I did the last week of June. Coming back this way, you can see it's really not that chunky as opposed to this one. So that's my HON. And this is something that I will definitely repurchase again for 2025. I love having everything in one book. And for this monthly layout, let's see, June, July. So it's prettier, more washi on the bottom versus this one where it doesn't have any. And then this one obviously has the same appointments as well as important dates on this page that I had in this one. So this is what we're doing in July. Let's go to the weekly layout. So this is the first week of July. And this one I do load up with the washi and the stickers. I think it came out okay. And now let's go into July. So this is the blank July monthly page. I'm probably gonna do a July memories page, which is what I did for June. Let me show you that one really quick, like this. I liked how this turned out. So this was the highlight for June, which I'm thinking about doing for July, but I won't decide what to do here until closer to the end of the month. And then these were two magazine cutouts. I haven't filled this part out yet because I'm not too sure if I want to fill it in with words or if I want to print out photos to put on these two pages. So here's a picture of Bruce. That is my niece's dog. Here I drew a picture of me and Bruce. I was trying to give him a hug. He seemed really receptive. And right when I was getting ready to hug him, I was close enough to do it, he burped in my face, which is why his muzzle, I drew his muzzle kind of wavy looking to show that he was burping, when I try to hug him. Over here is a tiny little note. A friend on Facebook sent me some shark fin melon seeds. So it's going to look like this when I harvest it, hopefully. I started 4 seeds on, was this Friday? So a week ago. I started 4 seeds, but she sent me a bunch. And I'm hoping it will grow. So I'm kind of excited, but that's the way I did that. 2 palmera flowers. This is a mango tree that I started from a pit. I think, I want to say it's 2 years ago, but this could be a year old. I need to look for my gardening journal that I did last year. And that's the wild carrots and my neighbor still. I do apologize. And then over here is a milkweed. It's a narrow leaf milkweed for the monarch butterfly. I started this from seed a couple years ago. And it finally bloomed this year. So I'm hoping to attract some monarch butterflies in the backyard. This is a native milkweed to Southern California, or to California. Over here is Bruce. So on Sunday, I started cleaning my room, which I call my library. My husband has his own room, which he uses as his work office. But I started cleaning it out. I've been trying to empty out the boxes, trying to organize that room better so that I can start filming in there, as well as moving my planners and things that I have in the kitchen nook into that room. But Bruce decided to come visit me while he was in there, so that's why there's a picture of him like this, and you can see all my junk on the all around him. And then here's me and Bruce later on that night where he was feeling kind of tired. This was Monday, so this was after the oncology visit. He was really, really tired. We went late in the day, late in the afternoon, and it was pretty warm that day. So he was pretty exhausted after the visit. So this is Tuesday. So this is what Bruce looks like when he's hungry. And I have my laptop that's right there on a TV tray. So lately he's been going around the TV tray and looking at me from under. So I was able to take a picture of that. There he is enjoying the warmth of the sun because the heat was coming in. And so he was laying right there. And then there's Bruce right there also letting me know that he wanted his afternoon snack. And that is a jung that had no peanuts. It's basically like a Chinese tamale that's wrapped up in some leaves. And it has like rice, salted egg, a Chinese sausage, some pork, some peanuts, some dried shrimp if you're into that, scallops. Every family makes it differently. But this is what my sister-in-law, my sister and I made a couple of weeks ago. But I ate the last one and it had no peanuts inside, which I made this for my dad and I was surprised that I didn't put any peanuts in there. But anyways, I ate the last one on Tuesday. I tried to draw some clownfish. So on a Facebook group called Strangest Facts, they posted this picture about clownfish and it says all clownfish are born as males. One female lives with a group of males, but only mates with only one of them. When she dies, her mate will become a female. This change is irreversible. I just thought that was so interesting. So drew the picture. Write it down. Next day, Strangest Facts on Facebook. This one says, watching your favorite movies over and over is good for you. The repetition calms you because knowing the outcome of a story helps you feel safe in an unpredictable world and it comforts you by recapturing lost feelings. So I was trying to think, what was a favorite movie of mine that I could watch over and over? And quite honestly, for me, it would be like old Agatha Christie movies when Poirot would be, who was the actor? Peter Ustinov. I love those cheesy 80 movies where he was Poirot. He portrayed Poirot. So that's why I drew the picture of Poirot and then in an old school TV. Because that's the version of movies that I could watch over and over because I just love it. And then today's Friday, so nothing there. So that is a quick look of my Hobonichi cousin and my A5 Hun. I hope you guys have a great weekend. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see after the moon videos, generally of my Hobonichi. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!